Paradox. How do you cope with a paradox? Chris Crandier, in his outstanding book, Paradoxology, describes a paradox in this way. A paradox, he says, just to be clear, consists of true statements that lead to an apparent or real contradiction in logic or intuition. Two statements that seem to contradict each other. When we come to celebrate the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, we are faced with the paradox of Christianity, the paradox of the kingdom of God. How is it that a dead carpenter can be worshipped around the world today as Lord and Savior? I think it's summed up for us in some words of the people who were mocking Jesus on the cross. They say to him, while he's on the cross, they mocked him. He saved others, but he can't save himself. The paradox here is how right they were and yet how wrong they were. They were right. He can't save others. And that would be the logical thinking as they stood there and watched Jesus on the cross and watched his life ebbing away. But the paradox is that he was, in fact, saving others. And not that he couldn't save himself, but rather that he wouldn't save himself so that he could save others, so that he could save you and me. This Easter, on Good Friday, we will look at the paradox of the kingdom, recognizing that it is in the death of one man that many have found life, that it is in the death of Jesus that we can live. I look forward to seeing you on Friday morning and sharing our time together online as we have in recent weeks. God bless you, and I'll see you tomorrow.